So we are in the business of mobile payments. As some of you might be aware that the ubiquity of mobile is driving many applications and payments is probably as basic as it gets. Some of the numbers here, 500 billion retail market in India, only 3% payments are processed on mobile. India has 600 million mobile phones, 200 million debit or credit card holders, and at least theoretically the potential is enough to probably drive 10 such businesses like us for the next 10 or 20 years. So what has really stopped things from happening is, one is, in India the regulator drives the market, they change rules, but at this point of time there is some sense of pragmatism coming in the market. While each year 7 to 8 million people join the white collar working segment, so they are potentially more prone to use payments using cards as against the traditional payers who used to use cash. So widespread belief that you can never replace cash in India is growingly becoming less and less tenable. India has about 300,000 merchants accepting cards, and mobile is an easy option for them to start for the ones who are not accepting. And what is more, the regulator is pushing top-level initiatives which basically will enable more and more transactions being moved to the cards. Now this is what our solution is. Till about September of this year, India had magnetic strip cards, and in one fell swoop, the entire market has kind of rebooted. So there are few companies like us, and it's sort of a starting point for everyone because the new solution has to be EMV chip and PIN compliant. What is more, as a further add-on to this, the regulator has also added that Aadhaar-enabled payment systems have to be implemented. That means each payer has an option to either use an EMV card with a chip and a PIN pad, and also an option not to provide the PIN and to use his biometric ID. So you're basically asking an entire payments infrastructure to adapt to some very fundamental changes. Now let's see what's the commercial impact of this. The various interest groups include the people who issue cards, the people who pay merchants who are called acquirers, the consumers themselves, and various interchange agents who basically make banks talk to each other. Now, for all of them, it means reduced cost, hopefully increased revenue. And when you say reduced cost, it means reduced cost upfront, which is the capex, and also reduced cost as you go forward, which is the opex. So in principle, this is something which will replace the classic point of sale devices once and for all, and for an ongoing purpose forever. So we have three segments. We have verticals by enterprise, small enterprises, small service providers like professionals, carpenters. Importantly, India is one of the first countries which is replacing ATMs with physical ATMs, which are being replaced by individuals who count cash and give it out instead of having a dispensing machine. So you're talking of 80 or 90% reduction in the capex and some similar amount in the operating expense.